It's always so busy, busy with the clinic, looking after the children.
We never get time to go out anymore. We used to go out all the time.
I know. Remember when we were in the World Guinness Book of Records for what?
Oh, we did dress up as a Smurf.
Yeah, the largest number of Smurfs in the world. When we head off to work in the morning, I know it's going to be great fun because I get to work with Kenny, my partner in crime.
It's always easy to work with your dream man.
Is it my turn then to set up a date?
I think so. It has to be fun, interactive, please.
Next Friday, bring a pair of heels and a snorkel.
Oh, I have heels and a snorkel.
I don't know. It's a date.
Okay, it's a date. It's a date. Morning, Stephanie.
Morning, guys.
Hey, you okay?
I'm well.
What's my patient list like today?
Well, you've got 8 patients, and Kenny, you have 3.
I've got a very busy day then. Let's go. Let's go, Marion. Let's go.
I'm Bobby. This is my son, Aaron. And we have a rare form of hyperkeratosis called focal palmoplantar keratoderma.
PPK is essentially keratosis that forms on your hands and feet.
I go up and down stairs on my hands and knees. If I didn't do it, I wouldn't move. Well, it's painful, you know. It's a kind of pain that means you can't get to sleep, and then when you do get to sleep, the possibility of it waking you up is completely random. And you're just like, what can I do about it? You know, I used to love going out dancing. Love music. I do like to dance. I think that is what I miss most. And I'm hoping that this will lead to some kind of pain control. I know it can't be cured, but I'd lead a better life if I wasn't always in pain. I've been using a wheelchair on and off for the last 20 years, and now I'm pretty much stuck in it.
Yes. So it's quite high pressure points on the metatarsal heads, yeah. And then on the heels itself. But yes, they look very, very thick. Which part of the foot is the most painful?
The bits that stick out at the side. Yeah.
And this is really over kind of how many years?
Well, 40.
40 yeah. years of yeah. build-up. I personally haven't seen PPK this bad in my entire career.
The thing I miss more than anything else in the world is dancing. Just enjoying the music and the physical activity of dancing, that's been very difficult.
Yeah, I can't imagine, you know, it sounds so painful, and I hope that we can do something for you. So when Bobby talked about her dancing, it just made me really sad because I dance with my children all the time. To lose something so simple, I just felt really, really sad at that moment. I usually don't recommend surgery for PPK patients because in theory I could do something, but this case is too extreme.
So how are you feeling about the amputation? I wonder if you're allowed to keep the toe.
I don't think it's like the dentist where you can ask for your tooth. Oh my God, can you imagine keeping it?
Have a little jar or something like that, yeah.
No, I don't want to keep the toe. But I will weigh less.
Yes.
The first thing to do is to take out the primary lesion. Okay, right. The first part of the surgery in terms of the corneal excision was relatively straightforward. That's easy to remove. It's the second part of the surgery, which is constructing the flaps and then getting them to close. And we want that first flap to rotate by about 90 degrees. That was a challenging one. So there's the lesion. That gives you an idea of how sticky out it was.
Yeah, it looks like an uncooked German sausage or something, doesn't it?
It does, yeah, it's the worst.
Yeah.
Anybody? No? Too late. The issue with the right foot is the corn that was forming over the metatarsal head. So there is our bone, almost completely exposed. So this is, you can see the lesions forming on that metatarsal head. So we're going to take that off now. That's the bone work we're going to do. We use a little power saw to take that off. So that all the way through the bone, you saw that give there. So we've done a through and through cut on the bone. You can see that's completely cut through there. So a full, what we call an osteotomy. So we're going to take that metatarsal head out now, as well as the whole of the digit.
Go on, you can do it.
I think I probably can. There's our metatarsal head. We're now going to come through and amputate the whole of that digit, taking away all of that digit, which is going to be superfluous. There's a couple of tendons to go through. And then there's the digit, fully amputated. So now it's a case of taking out the lesion. Just a little bit of soft tissue just to avoid there. So we've got the lesion out. As per the plan, Bobby, so that bone is gone.
Excellent.
The toe is gone, the corner's gone.
Yeah.
But we'll get that closed.
Can I have a look?
So there's the lesion. So again, we've taken an elliptical lesion out there. Wonderful. And then the toe.
Oh, bye-bye toe. Yeah, bye-bye.
So that's all gone.
It's the start of discovery. And I'm really excited.
Are you walking?
Well, let's not exaggerate here.
That is amazing. Look at you.
But I'm in training, okay? So
you're in training.
Can't go far.
That was a very wonderful walk up and down. That is amazing.
It is good, isn't it? Over the last couple of weeks, I've managed to get socks on and shoes on, and it's changed my life completely.
She looks like a completely different person. You can see the smile, the positivity on her face. It is wonderful. And look at the result.
Yes.
Where is the corn?
Completely gone.
It is completely gone. Side. This is amazing. Mm-hmm. Ian has done a really fantastic job. It's healed so well.
It has, hasn't
the
it?
The scar is so minimal.
Yeah.
I'm really, really happy.
Well, I'm very happy for me.
I feel like you're a completely different person from when we first met.
You know, I don't know where this is going to take me yet, but I'm back on my feet and it feels great.
Hello, welcome.
Hi.
What's your name?
Craig, I'm here to see Marion.
Okay, amazing. Okay, take a seat for me.
Thank you.
My feet smell disgusting, enough to clear a room. I have a fungal nail infection that's lasted over 25 years. It's impacted me on shoes that I can wear, and they often rub against any shoes I've got on. They feel very painful. I'm engaged to my partner, Lindsay. We're hoping to get married next summer. If I don't get my feet sorted, I'll have to wear boots on my wedding day. It makes me feel really sad that I might have to compromise on my wedding day.
So, tell me about your foot problem.
Yeah, it started about 25 years ago when I was in the army. I developed like a form of trench foot.
Mm.
The skin started peeling.
Yes.
And it never got better.
Mm.
And then it developed into like a foot fungus.
All makes sense because you're in so much moisture when you're kind of in the army, you're wearing tight shoes, walking long distance and everything. Let's take off your shoes and socks. Let's have a look, okay?
Lovely.
Okay, dokie. So, I can see a few things going on with your nails. You definitely have a fungal infection. You can see the yellow discoloration in the nails, the thickening of the nails. That's because the fungus is using the nail plate as food source and making it thick and yellow. And you can see that the fungal infections has really, really deformed the nail. Fungal nail infection, or what we call it in podiatry, onychomycosis, is a very common nail condition. Not everyone can treat it like myself. I am an expert. So how does it affect your day-to-day life?
It can be really difficult because it affects my confidence to get my feet out.
Yeah.
My fiancé gets quite frustrated
when
I won't go anywhere with them.
And when are you guys getting married?
It should be July next year.
Excellent. We've got plenty of time to treat your infection, and they'll be feet perfect. So there's really a couple of things that you could try in terms of treating a fungal nail infection. And that is kind of cutting it back,
Then there is laser treatments. I think it's too severe for it to work, to be honest. Then there is nail surgery. So the point of nail surgery is to remove the nail and then see how they grow back. And I think it's definitely worthwhile. There's always a chance that it may grow back with a fungal infection, because that's medicine, but hopefully they won't grow back with a fungal infection. We've got a wedding to go to.
We do.
So I'm gonna get Stephanie to come in and help me today. The worst part of nail surgery is actually the injection of local anesthetic. We have so many nerve endings in our toes to feel the ground, and when we put that needle in, it's really, really painful. 1, 2, 3, and go. Yeah, and breathe in and out for me, please. Relax, relax.
So when Marion does her injections, I hold their hands, they squeeze my hands. I've had one person who really squeezed my hand really hard one time. It actually really hurt me. But it's okay. If it helps them, it's fine.
Are you okay?
Yeah, yeah, keep going.
Keep going. I like that. Courage. That's from the army, isn't it?
Yeah.
Amazing. I'm gonna just put this tunicate. This is to restrict the blood flow, okay, around the toes. So Craig, let's go. So I'm just going underneath the nail, and I'm just popping it out. And cast it in. You can hear that kind of crunchy noise.
The best part about pulling the toenail off is that noise when you remove it from the nail matrix and it goes kick it, bop, bop.
You feeling it? Are you okay?
I'm fine. It looks strange pulling nails out. Mm. It's almost like torture, yeah, but you don't feel the pain.
You don't feel it. But they use it, right? They use it as a source of torture in the olden days, medieval days, right?
Yeah.
Like, I'll tell you everything! So we're just gonna remove this one. It's a tough little burger. Doesn't want to come off today. You'll be mine. Come on, be one. Oh, yes! It did come off in one piece. Yeah, look at that!
It's huge.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you, dressing, please. But it's all done. You should feel a lot lighter now, huh? 7 nails lighter. Okay. So you did really, really well. Well done. And now we're just waiting for the nails to grow back, and fingers crossed, right?
Oh my gosh, how have you got on?
They're taking 7 nails out.
7? Come on then, let's get you home.
It must go slow, because it hurts.
So it's been 3.5 months since I removed your nails. How are you doing?
I'm doing really well, thanks. My nails have been really good since you removed them. There's no sign of any infection coming back. The athlete's foot's completely gone. Since having the infected nails out, you know, my toenails look normal.
They look amazing.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. There's no scaling, there's no athlete's foot, there's no dead skin. And it's been many, many years since I've had that.
So I'm really, really happy. And the nails are growing out. It's only been 3.5 months. They've grown out really, really quite quickly.
Yes, yeah, they have. The small nails are nearly there.
Yes.
And the big nails, probably about a quarter.
I think in another 2 or 3 months, they should completely grow out. So I'm really, really happy.
When I look down, I've got normal feet, normal nails, could wear normal shoes, and there's no pain, which is the main thing.
Fantastic.
I appreciate all the treatment and support.
It's been a pleasure. I'm really, really, really happy with the results. One final question. Have you bought those wedding shoes we talked about during our consultation?
I've not gone out and bought them yet, but I'm confident enough to go out and start looking for them. We bought the wedding dress, so I think the next step is to buy my shoes.
I wish you all the best. Have a wonderful wedding. Bye-bye.
Bye.